So this is a bit of a weird video, but I'm trying to multitask, and I'm also going to talk about something quite difficult. So this is a way of making this more comfortable for me. How am I doing as an ordinand at Cranmer Hall? Things have been interesting this term. We've done 2 weeks of block teaching on sex and gender. We've done Schools Week. And as you can probably guess from this, it's Pride this weekend, so I'm doing my nails all the colours of the rainbow. I'm doing the intercessions at the Pride service, which I'm excited by. Okay, so after my enigmatic start, what do I want to talk about? I want to talk about mental health. It is a well-acknowledged thing that, well, life is stressful, right? I think most people feel stress at some point in their lives, and they'll feel anxious about things. Everyone has some level of mental health. A lot of people have very healthy mental health. It's all fine. Some people have chronically terrible mental health. Now, I've been normally in the first category. I'm neurotypical and I've never been diagnosed with anything, and I suspect I don't think I've had clinical anxiety. I might have had a stint of something that might have been called clinical depression in my second year of university, the first time, but I don't know. What I do know is that over the last few years of learning to be an adult, basically, I have learnt that, like everybody, I have mental health needs. Just like being physically healthy, you have to do things. When I started working for the church, I realised that I had been very lucky as a stage manager because I had socialised with people all day, every day. I'd had a lot of time with people, and so I'd not noticed any problem with my mental health. But being in an office, suddenly I needed to think about what my mental health needed, because it took me about 3 months to realise that I was symptomatic of bad mental health. My symptoms included being tired all the time, totally tired for no obvious reason. I hadn't physically tired myself out. I was sleeping fine, I was eating fine. There was no physical reason for me to be tired. After 3 months, I went home. So, you know, I had been socialising, but I've been socialising the way that I had when I was a stage manager. And I went home and I found that I felt a lot better and I wasn't tired all the time because I was spending all day with my family. And I was like, oh, I see. I'm an extrovert and I need to spend quality time with people who are close to me and have known me a long time for me to be mentally healthy. I learned that a few years ago. So you'd think, oh, okay, you've solved that, so you're just going to keep doing that. Yes, you'd think so. But we all work out that we need to sleep healthier and eat healthier, but we don't always. If we're not thinking about it, we can put ourselves in silly situations. Now, you can probably guess what's coming next. These last couple of terms had obviously been stressful. Everything's stressful in time, but, you know, being an ordinand is a particular stress with particular challenges. One of those challenges is, again, you know, learning yourself what you need and what that means in this context. So I did quite well in the first term of being like, okay, I'm probably going to mess this up, but I'm going to learn what I need. And I did, and I implemented that in the second term, and last term was really good. 5 weeks into this term, in the last week and a half, I started noticing symptoms again. I noticed that I was tired all the time, which was the main one. I noticed that I was grumpy. I wasn't able to filter. I also noticed, now anyone who was assigned female at birth and has gone through puberty will recognise the symptoms of PMS or PMT or whatever you call it. And then I was sort of getting a few of those, you know. I was achy and I was emotional. I start crying at nothing. Absolutely no reason at all. And that didn't make sense hormonally. And it went on for too long for it to be hormonal. And I realised, okay, what haven't I been doing for my mental health? I haven't been talking to the people who've known me for a long time and who love me. You know, I've been talking to people at college and stuff, but it's a different thing that I need. I've been drinking more than I usually do at a few nights where I had gin. Okay, this rainbow has not gone very well. Ugh. That's always the problem with the first one. So I had these symptoms, and then I figured out what I had done. The fact that I had messed up in what I understood to be my... Now, I'm not blaming myself any more than I would blame somebody who got unfit. There's always circumstances that contribute to these things. But this is part of my ministry curve, right? Understanding myself and what I need. Now, again, I'll reiterate that I understand that I am very lucky. I don't have chronic mental health issues. This is just an acute episode that I can recognise how to fix, or at least I can try. I'll get back to you if I fail. And for anyone who does know me IRL and are worried by this, don't be. It's okay. I'll call you if need be. This is not a cry for help or a crisis point. This is me documenting what is part of being an ordinand. And what is probably part of being a priest as well, I highly suspect. And it's all about working out what you need and also what your coping mechanisms are. This last week, once I'd realised what I had done, I was like, okay, you need to do things that will help. So one of the things that I hadn't been coping with because my mental health was deteriorating was being on top of things. And that sort of spiraled and added to the problems. Feeling on top of things is important to me. Feeling like I'm in control. And normally I can cope if things get a bit wobbly. But because I hadn't been doing my self-care, I haven't been coping with not feeling on top of things. So today has been a me time day where I've been doing my chores. I'm also prioritizing what I want to do over what I think I should do, which is another important thing. What I want to be doing is this. Rainbows! Yay! Doing pride preparations. I love pride. There's so few times in a year we get to celebrate who we are. Our birthday is one of them. Christmas is another if you're lucky enough to be able to celebrate who you are as part of something bigger, whether it's biological family or chosen family. But pride is being proud of something that is both being part of something bigger and about who you are. It also means I can get a little bit creative, which is always fun. Do my nails, get my face paints out. So I've prioritised that today. This was my only thing on my to-do list. I've done a few other things this morning, but they weren't, this is what I must get done today. I only had one thing and it's something I want to do. For example, I was supposed to go for a run this morning and my other activities meant I overran. That's ironic. My timing overran and I haven't been able to get out to a run. But because it wasn't on my to-do list as something that had to get done, I'm not letting myself stress about it. So I've set it up so that I can not stress about it. I'll also be watching a film to let these dry. I haven't worked out what film I want to watch yet, but it'll be something feel good. It'll be something I know and I've watched before. I'm basically indulging myself. Because, one of the things that stress me out sometimes is the fact that I don't get to watch as much films as I would want. Anyway, I just wanted to share part of the journey. Might be a bit more ugly than some parts of the journey, but God's here too, and I'd be in a lot more mess, I suspect, if God wasn't here. The fact that I'm part of a worshiping community also helps. Prayer with other people has been good. I've got friends here who I suspect have also thrown up a few prayers for me because I have been a bit of a moody cow. And apologies to everybody who's been affected by that. Being in a bad mood is no excuse for behaviour, but it is a reason. This is the thing, there's been no trigger. There's no been big thing. It's just been a little bit of self-neglect. Not abusive, but just not being conscious of my needs. I'm not sure these rainbows are going very well. Sorry this has been a long one, but it was important. I thought I'd give you a little bit of insight. That's what my hope is for this blog. There's a little bit of insight. And a lot of things I go through here are microcosms of what happens in ministry. Time and again, it comes back to learning yourself in relation to God and to others. It's a simple and oft-repeated message. That just shows how important it is. It's one of my philosophies in my faith that to draw closer to God is to draw closer to the truth. And the only truth that you have a chance of really getting close to is the truth of who you are. Get closer to that and you'll draw nearer to God. I said it to myself over and over and it still needs saying. That I don't beat myself up about. Things I have control over are working on the things that I already know about myself, which is what I have not quite done now. The only things I try and worry about are the things I have control over, which is not a lot. Hopefully these nails will turn out alright. I'm not 100% though. Oh dear. That's how they're looking at the moment. Vaguely the right effect, eh?